A very pleasant morning to all my dear children. Welcome back to English Online class, Sri Gokulam Public School, Guruvayur. I hope you all had a great time during Christmas, isn't it, children? Yes. Okay, then let's get back to our studies. Let's continue with our lesson 8, Jalebis from our supplementary reader text, It So Happened. The short story, Jalebis, is written by Ahmad Nadeem Qasmi, who was an Urdu language Pakistani poet, journalist, dramatist, and also a short story writer. He wrote 50 books on several topics. He also received awards like Pride of Performance and also Sitare Imtiaz for his literary works. Sitare Imtiaz is the third highest honor and civilian award in the state of Pakistan, as we have Padma Bhushan in India. We almost covered the first part of the story. So today let's discuss the second part of the story. This short story, Jalebis, is a story adapted from the author's life. It is his experience. He narrates an incident that happened when he was in 5th standard at the government school in Kampalpur, the place now it is known as Attic. This incident happened on the day when he went to the school with 4 rupees to pay the school fees and fund. Unfortunately, Master Ghulam Mohammed, the master who collected the school fees, was on leave that day. The coins had remained silent throughout the day in his pockets. But once when he stepped outside the school, when the school got over, the coins started speaking. The speaking of the coins is actually the fanciful imagination of this little boy. It is his temptation to eat the jalebis. It is his desire to have the jalebi. What do you mean by temptation, children? Suppose your mother gives you 2 chocolates, one for you and one for your younger brother or sister. And what you do, you eat your chocolate and you keep the other one for your brother or sister. And they didn't return after a long time and you are really tempted at the sight of that chocolate. And finally, you couldn't stop your temptation or you couldn't prevent your temptation and you finally eat up that chocolate. So temptation is a desire to do something, especially wrong thing. In spite of all his temptations and persuasions of the coins, our hero, he didn't get swept away by all these persuasions. He returned home. That's where we stopped. So children, what is the meaning of persuasion? Persuasion also means coaxing. It means to make someone do something by certain arguments or by reasoning. For example, your friend is a very talented singer or dancer, but exactly at the moment of the competition, he or she loses their confidence. So you persuade them by your motivating words, by making certain arguments. You can tell them that you are the best performer than all other performers in the competition. So you can give such arguments, you can give such valid arguments to make them persuade or to make them do something. So that is persuasion. Even when the boy reached home, the coins kept disturbing him and persuaded him to buy the jalebis. So after having his lunch, he rushed to the bazaar. Bazaar means market. And he ordered jalebis worth 1 rupee. So he got a heap of jalebis from the halwai. Halwai is a person who sells sweets, a confectioner. So the person who translated this story, Sufia Pathan, had made use of some Urdu words like bazaar, halwai, jalebis, and we are familiar with these words because we make use of these words in the northern parts of India, isn't it? Yes. So we are familiar with these words and Urdu has some similarities with the Hindi language. So we are already familiar with these words. So this halwai, he gave an astonished look. He gave a surprised look. Why this halwai was surprised? Because for a rupee, we get a heap of jalebis. He was wondering where, how this boy would carry the heap of jalebis to his home, whether he had bought a handcart with him. So with this stops the first part of the story. So the first part, this boy is really tempted by the sight of crisp, fresh, mouth-watering jalebis. So he finally buys the jalebis. Now let's move to the second part of the story. In the second part, we can see that the boy is really happy because he received the jalebis from the halwai and he was about to move to have it. At that time, he saw his uncle, his Chacha Jan, returning from the court in their tonga. Tonga is a two-wheeled vehicle which is drawn by horses. So when he saw his Chacha Jan returning from the court, he rushed to the gully. He ran to the gully. Gully is a narrow lane, a narrow road which is seen in the village areas. So when he reached a safe corner, he devoured means eat quickly. He devoured the jalebis in his hand, and he was so pleased because now his stomach was full. At that time, the boys of the entire neighborhood came there, gathered there. So what did he do? He shared the remaining jalebis with them. The news got spread. The happy news got spread. What is the happy news? That a boy is distributing jalebis. This news got spread, and a whole lot of other children also gathered there. Beggars also came to get this jalebis. Assault means attack. Here no one is attacking, but they also joined this group. So there was a huge mob or a huge crowd before him. But the jalebis were not sufficient. The jalebis in his hand were not sufficient for all of them. So what did he do? He again rushed to the halwai and he bought again jalebis worth 1 rupee for 1 rupee. So he again got a heap of jalebis. So this time what did he do? He stood on the chabutra. Chabutra means a platform of a house. He stood on the platform of a house and he distributed the jalebis to each and every person who was standing in front of him. So when he was distributing this jalebi standing on the platform of a house, he felt like a governor sahib who would distribute rice to the poor and needy on the Independence Day. So he felt like a governor, and he also felt that if there were elections for the children, he would surely win the election. He also says that just a signal by his jalebi wielding hand. Jalebi wielding hand means the hand that held jalebis, the hand that holds jalebis, just a signal or just any type of waving by his jalebi wielding hand would make the mob, the crowd in front of him, willing to kill anyone or get killed. They would be ready to do anything for him. They would sacrifice even their lives for him. Amunna's social service does not end here. He again bought jalebis with the remaining 2 rupees and distributed it among the mob in front of him. He then washed his hands and mouth and returned to home by putting on an innocent face as if he hadn't seen jalebis in his lifetime. But when he reached home, the fear was killing him. What was that fear, children? The fear that with every breath, he was having a burp. Burp means a release of gas from our mouth when our stomachs are full. We all will have burp, isn't it? Yes. So he feared that with every breath is having a burp, and with every burp whether the jalebi would come out or not. So he feared that the jalebi would come out of his mouth. He was also thinking about excuses for not having dinner at night because his stomach was full, so he cannot have dinner. So he was thinking about excuses, what excuses he would make to his parents. So he thought that he would pretend illness, that he is sick. So if he pretended illness, his parents would summon the doctor. Summon means they would call the doctor. And once the doctor feel his pulse or check his pulse, the doctor would say that this boy had gobbled heap of jalebis. And such comment would make him die of fright. So he had such fear in his mind. He also says that there is a saying, when children speak, flowers shower from their mouth. Flowers will pour out from their mouth. But he would be the first child whose every word would shower jalebi. So he had all such fears. So he lay down and coiled up like a jalebi. Munna then says that children don't have stomachs. They have only digestion machines. What does he mean by this statement? He means that children can eat any large amount of food. They can eat any large quantity of food and it would get digested gradually. So in the morning when he got up, he had no problems. Last night he had stomach ache, but in the morning when he got up, he had no problems. So he washed his face and just like a virtuous student, just like a good student, he took up a slate and the chalk and he headed for the school. So in those olden times, we didn't have any notebooks or textbooks. We had only chalk and slate. On his way to school, he thought that today he will get his scholarship money, and with that money he can pay the school fees. So he was really happy by such thoughts, and he also felt that with this, the story of the jalebis will also get over. So he was heading to school with such good thoughts in his mind. When Munna reached school, he found that the scholarship money would be paid only in the next month. And he also heard the announcement that Master Ghulam Mohammed would collect the school fees during the recess, means during the interval. So all this announcement terrified him. He was really frightened and he felt like that his head was spinning, it was turning round, and he also felt that he was standing on his head. So when the recess bell rang, when the interval bell rang, he tucked his bag under his arm and he left the school. He thought that he'll walk or he'll head to the point where the earth ended and the sky began. So when he reached such a point, he would request Allah Mia, he would request the God to send a farista, to send an angel to give him 4 rupees. And he would also request God, or he will also beg God, that he will use this money to pay the school fees and he will not eat jalebis with them. So he thought that he will make such request. Even though he walked some distance, he couldn't find such a point where the earth ended and where the sky began. But he saw a point where the Kampalpur railway station began. And at that time, he remembered 2 warnings given by his elders. Which were those 2 warnings? The first warning is that he should never cross the railway track. He should never get the other side of the railway track. And the second warning is that he should never eat sweets with the fees money. So Mulla was wondering how he had forgotten all the valuable instructions given by his elders. So with the grief of Mulla, with the sadness of Mulla, stops our second part. Let's see whether he would escape the situation smoothly in our next part, in the third part, in our next session. So children, I hope you enjoyed the story. I hope you understood the story. So it's time to wind up the session. That's all for today. See you in the next class.